Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at using Google Voice Search on the iPhone. So Android phones don't have Siri, but they do have voice recognition capability. And you can get a lot of those functions on your iPhone by simply using the standard Google app. So on my iPhone here, I'm going to go into the Google app, which is free to download, and I can do various things in here. I can, for instance, do a search. It looks just like the Google homepage. I can just do it by typing. I can access other apps, for instance, inside. So I can access calendar information, for instance. I can even use the new Google Now functionality. But for now, I'm just going to focus on voice, which is that button there at the bottom center. And I can ask it a question. So, for instance, I can ask it something basic like the weather. What's the weather going to be like tomorrow?
Tomorrow's forecast for Denver is 75 degrees with a chance of storm.
So a couple things here. First of all, you saw how good the voice recognition was, and it does seem to be a little superior to Siri. Second of all, you saw that it responded immediately. It actually showed me on the screen what it was doing. So it's actually doing the translation from my voice into text live on my phone. It's not sending it into a server like Siri does. And of course, it will use your phone. For instance, your phone knows your location, so it'll use that to give answers. So for instance, I can ask this. What's the best Chinese restaurant nearby?
There are several listings for the best Chinese restaurant nearby within 10 miles.
So what else can you use it for? Well, a lot of the standard stuff that you could do with Siri. So for instance, sports stuff. What are the National League West standings? How is Apple stock doing today?
Apple is currently trading at $443.81.
Multiply 42 times 13. Notice how it wouldn't give me the actual answer there because I didn't phrase it correctly. So just like Siri, you have to phrase things correctly sometimes. What is 42 times 13?
The answer is 546.
You can also use it for movie times and traffic. What movies open this Friday?
Movies playing in Denver on Friday.
What's traffic like on I-25?
Showing traffic for Interstate 25.
Now you can also get directions. So for instance, I can do this. Give me directions to the Central Park Recreational Center.
Stapleton Recreation Center is 15 minutes from your location by car. Here are your directions.
Now if I tap on the map, it actually will open the Google Maps app and load up directions for that. So that's a little different than, of course, Siri. Siri would take you to the Apple Maps app. So if you like using Google Maps and you want to do some sort of voice recognition to give you directions while driving, then using the Google app with voice search will be the way to start that. Now, as you would expect, Google Voice Search does great for searching the web. Tell me about Isaac Newton.
Here is some information about Isaac Newton.
You can also just do image search pretty easily. Show me some images of the Eiffel Tower.
Take a look at these pictures of the Eiffel Tower.
Now the downside is there's no integration with iOS, so you can't use it for things like reading and sending text messages, you can't create reminders and events, you can't play music from your iTunes collection, or use it for just general dictation. But Siri does all that, and there's no reason you can't use both of these. So some people may prefer for some of these functions to launch the Google app first and do them, while other functions just use Siri because it integrates nicely with iOS. So Google Voice is one of those things that since it's free you might as well have on your iPhone as an alternative to Siri, and you may find that for searching and for some other things it comes in handy. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.